bring up, especially in communities where everyone knows everyone and there might not be as many resources.
But one group in Iowa County has taken on the tough task of getting people in more rural towns talking about mental health. Susan Springer Judge has been at the forefront of that effort. She's here to talk about ways you can help too. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. Let's start with your coalition. Why did you start this? Did you see a need, particularly in rural communities?
Yeah, I did. Actually, in 2012, I lost my brother to suicide, and I started the coalition in 2014. And we actually started out in Iowa County, but we've expanded to total of 7 counties because of the need, and people just kept asking for trainings and help and awareness in their areas.
What are you hearing from people when they ask you about it?
They just want to find ways to talk about it, to break down the stigmas that people don't feel they can talk about suicide because it's an embarrassing, it's shameful, and that's not what it should be, especially with all of our military coming back, with the post-traumatic stress, with our farmers and the finances and everything, and just any mental health issues. They should be able to talk about it and feel comfortable talking about it.
So in your years doing this, have you been surprised by the willingness of people to open up about this?
Pleasantly surprised, actually. The first thing I did was a basketball game. One of our awareness things was a basketball game in Dodgeville where we had all the shirts that we gave away to the players and everything. And I was waiting for the backlash to come back, and it never did. Everybody was really excited that we were talking about it in a fun way. It wasn't a, because it's a heavy subject, obviously. It's a very heavy subject. And yeah, we got it out there in a fun way to the youth and their parents. And that's what we keep doing.
We're taking a look at some pictures from last year's event. Our very own Danica Lewis was there as well. I wonder if we have any pictures of her.
No, I took these. So
There you go.
Okay. I was behind the camera this time.
Yeah, you'll be back this year, though. And in our presence is this massive trophy.
Yes,
huh?
This is a first place trophy.
Go ahead, the big reveal.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah.
You're born right there.
Encouraging thing to try to win on Sunday. We need more teams.
Yeah.
So I hope people go on our website and register. We would love to have more teams.
I mean, look at this.
If that doesn't convince you, nothing will.
And we are talking, just in case people didn't notice in the pictures there, we are talking dodgeball here.
Right.
Yeah,
dodgeball.
5-on-5, right? Can you give some details?
5-on-5, it's co-ed, so you have to start out your games with at least 2 males and 2 females.
Yep.
You can have a couple on your bench, but you can't sub anybody in until the next game. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. So everybody has a good time. And the money all goes towards suicide prevention. How can you beat that?
Yeah. And that's, I was going to add, you know, specifically you guys are trying to do a radio PSA, making sure that you can do exactly what you were mentioning with the basketball games, handing out information and making sure that's getting out there. And then this training that you guys are doing.
Yes.
Yeah, the QPR trainings, it's question, persuade, refer. And it's going really well. We've been doing it for the last couple of years. We're training EMTs, police officers, teachers, anybody in the community that want to come. And we're having a lot of success. We just want to keep it going, keep the motivation rolling.
Register by tomorrow. Let's do it. Dodgeball. Thank you so much for coming in again, Sue.
Great. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it.
Of course. Yeah. Well, if it's not dodgeball, then it's basketball on the minds of a lot of folks this time of year. Coming up, we're going to tell you how a scholarship created in the memory of a Verona teenager is helping a Wisconsin college team make it to a national tournament.
Might be able to shoot some hoops outside today. We won't have much of the sun for the first day of spring, but Hattie will tell us.